of St. Joseph Convent Girls High School, one Karnataka girls battalion, is here to talk about Quit India Movement. Quit India Movement was the final mass-based movement launched to secure India's independence. It was launched during Second World War. Three major reasons are attributed to the launch of the movement are the Indian nationalists and the British government could not reach any form of agreement over Indian demands for independence. Japan had already acquired large portions of Southeast Asia and there was high possibilities of Japanese invasion over India. Indian people were facing economic hardships on account of ongoing World War. The essential commodities were available at very high prices. On August 8, 1942, Congress leaders held a meeting at Gwalior Tank, Maidan, Bombay. During the meet, Mahatma Gandhi, during his speech, addressed the British to quit India on their own or face mass agitations. Gandhiji made the mantra of do or die. He further elaborated that Indians shall free or die in an attempt. Gandhiji permitted the use of violence for the first time. Although Gandhiji favoured non-violence, during World War II, any peaceful protest was not allowed because of emergency conditions. Thus, Congress was left with only one option of a violent movement. Gandhiji issued specific instructions through various sections of Indian society. He asked government servants not to resign but to declare their allegiance to Congress. This is because continuous functioning of government servants was essential to maintain continuity of administrations. Soldiers were asked to stay in the army and to not fire on the compatriots. It was important soldiers continued to work in the army and because otherwise there would be problems for national defense. The students, if confident, could leave studies and participate in the movement. This is because youth has an important role to play in the movement. The movement took place in three phases. The first phase started with immediate arrest of all leaders. Congress was banned, whereas officials were sealed and press of freedom was curbed to prevent every possible political activity. However, people were familiar with the agenda of the movement. There were attacks on British officials, government buildings and buses and other symbols of authority. In the second phase, the movement, which started out from Bombay, spread to various parts of the country to many places. British rules were eliminated completely and parallel governments were set up. The third phase was estimated as an underground movement secretly organized by Congress Socialist Party. The notable leaders were Ram Manohar